They're about to take this whale away. But I think if we just take a peek, we can see my favorite organ. If you follow this passageway into here, see where my hand is going? Right here on this side of my hand is a pair of lips. They look kind of like the muzzle of a monkey, and therefore the first person who described it called it the museau de singe, which means the monkey's muzzle, or sometimes loosely translated as monkey lips. And if we just part this in here and look inside, you can see that cleft of the between the two lips right there. I'm gonna try and put the knife blade in so you can see that, but that's the cleft right there. Right there, see that lip that's moving? That is the monkey's lips. And air is actually coming out between those two lips and into this pocket that my hands are in. This pocket that's right here is simply a space to allow those lips to vibrate. And when they vibrate, these lips are attached to all that spermaceti oil that we saw. So as air is popping out of those lips, it's vibrating the spermaceti oil. Now what's really interesting is the air popping out of these lips exits up in here, or it can be sucked back in through the other nasal passageway and go back down to the lungs again and be recycled. But the air that's coming through those lips is coming from deep in those lips from another separate pathway deeper in the head that's coming up to this part of the nose, to one nostril.
Here is the key to the sperm whale's titanic song. Hidden deep inside its head is a second nasal passage that shares the single nostril. When air runs through the monkey lips, they slap together. This is what makes the sound of the whale's click. It's an extraordinary example of evolution. One part of its nose breathes, the other sings.
So we've got a really big hole for breathing because they got to evacuate all the air like a sneeze, and a really tiny hole for making sounds, kind of like when you squeeze the balloon and you let little tiny squeaks out from the balloon. That's what they're doing right here. This is the part where you squeeze the balloon, and when it comes out as a click, as these two lips go smack, 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 smack. That's the click that's needed for echolocation. And that click has to then travel from this sound generator through this sound modifier to a reflector in the back, which is also made out of air, then through a series of condensing lenses, which is on the other side of this head, and finally out of the skull, here. Right here, out of the front of the head. So this is where the sound comes out. This is where the sound is made. So it's got to go all the way to the front, go all the way to the back, and come all the way to the front again before it actually comes out. It's an amazing path. Very cool. Okay. Now they can take the whale away.